Canada had some pretty amazing rock and roll bands during the 70s and 80s. There was Prism and Trooper and Max Webster, Rush, Bare Naked Ladies, a whole slew of them. We were lucky enough to have quite a few of them on our television show. And when they came to the studio, we would turn the studio into a rock and roll venue. It was always fun. The production was amazing on most of these rock bands. So we had a band called Prism on the show for this excerpt that I'm about to bring you. They were singing their hit song called Armageddon. The lead singer, Ron Tabak, came to a kind of tragic end in 1984. This would have been, you know, about 5 years after this was recorded. I was talking to a friend of his, maybe it was one of his band members, and he had told me the story of his death. I'm going to read you what it says on the internet. I was sad to hear of the untimely death of Prism's lead singer Ron Tabak in 1984. It was Christmas and a member of the band, Alan Harlow, had invited him over for Christmas dinner. Harlow lived in Kitsilano and Ron lived in Surrey. Ron decided to get some exercise and rode his bicycle over to Al Harlow's house. However, it was that time of year when the roads were kind of slippery. Unfortunately, he wasn't wearing a helmet and he didn't have a light on his bicycle. A car must have struck him, knocking him to the ground. He was taken to the hospital and he became abusive and aggressive towards the police. Apparently, that was very much unlike him. He was a gentle guy. He was arrested and put in jail. He was found unconscious in his cell and he died the following day. He had developed a blood clot, I guess, when he hit his head, and that had made him aggressive towards the police. He never regained consciousness, and he passed away on December 26, 1984. It was a sad and unnecessary death. It's a good thing we don't know what's going on in front of us, and we can only see what happened behind us, because I'm sure there's a lot of things we would never want to know. Anyway, here is Prism with Ron Tabak singing Armageddon, one of their big smash hits, on the Raes, 1980.
If you wonder what it takes for a Canadian group to make it big, listen to the sound that's coming up next.
Now, each member of this five-man group is a perfectionist, and their approach to music is precise and powerful.
Their concerts are classics wherever they choose to perform.
What inspired you to write Armageddon?
I wrote Armageddon in Memphis in 1978 during the police strike. It was also the first anniversary of Elvis Presley's death. And so it was rather unusual to National Guard with their bayonets and their helmets and their half tracks, mm-hmm. and these tourists worshiping Elvis Presley's shrine. It was rather unusual.
Ladies and gentlemen,
Prism.